Hi, welcome to Spine Educational Channel. In this video, we will talk about skins in spine. What are skins? Why do we need them? How to create them? And lastly, some example projects with skins implemented. Before you can take anything from this video, please note that this is not an official spine channel. While I'm very careful with the information I share, I'm just a guy who has some free time to share his experience. Let's begin by understanding what are skins in spine. Skins allow animations to be reused with different attachments, which means we can use same bones and animations to animate multiple characters that look different but share similar proportions. In this example, we can see that all skins are packed inside one texture atlas. And with some script, we can randomize the parts, which can be very useful in some cases. At the moment, in spine, skins can contain attachments, bones, and constraints. Note that attachment doesn't mean image. We can have multiple attachments that point to the same image. The official term for image in spine is region or mesh attachment. These are the only attachment types that can contain images. As you can guess, we also have attachment types that can't contain images. They are for technical purposes, such as path, bounding box, clipping, and point attachments. Nice! This was a little intro about attachments, since we will be working with them a lot in this video. Now back to the skins. So, we can add any type of attachments to skins. And by adding region or mesh attachments to skin, we can swap entire body or maybe just outfits. Well, with all that, we can create all kind of customizable characters, right? Not really. And here is why. Sometimes skin has different shapes. Or maybe it adds new attachments that are specific only for that particular skin. In those cases, we can add more bones to the main rig. But that would clutter the view and more importantly affect the performance if we load all extra bones that come with each skin. So, we just add those bones into their corresponding skins. That will make sure that each skin activates bones that are rigged specifically for that particular skin. Now that we can add bones and attachments to skin, we really can create some flexible skins by reusing same animations and most of the rig. But wait, spine also gives us ability to add constraints to skin. With that, we can also store different proportions under different skins and much more. Cool, now let's create a simple skin that contains two attachments for shoes. Let's make them blue. I use Spineboy example project, which you can find in default examples. Here. You can see that at the moment, in the tree, skin node is empty. That means that all attachments are in default skin, which is not visible here, but in the game engine, you should see it. You can also see it in the exported JSON. To create a new skin, select skin node, open new menu, and click on the skin option. Now give it a name. If we export JSON file, Spine will warn us that red skin has no attachments. However, Spine did export JSON file, and we can see that it contains two skins, default and red. You see? At the moment, red skin is empty. That means all attachments are still inside default skin, which, as I said previously, is not visible in the Spine editor. We can only see red skin. To put the shoes inside the skin, we need to select these attachments, open new menu, and create skin placeholder. Let's ignore this pop-up for now. We will come back to it later when we work with multiple skins. Click OK. Right after that, those two attachments will be placed inside skin placeholders with hanger icons. Any attachment that's inside the skin placeholder belongs to the skin that is active at the moment. I should also mention that only one skin can be active at a time. you can see a bright circle near the active skin. Important note: you can't create a skin placeholder if there is no active skin. If I click on this circle, it will deactivate the skin and we won't be able to create any placeholder. So don't be confused when you see this option disabled. You can also see that placeholders of the shoes are empty now. Where are the shoes? Confused? I hope not. Let me activate red skin back, so we can see them again. Next, I will duplicate red skin and name it blue. Great, we have two skins, one for blue and the other for red shoes. Let's activate blue skin and change attachment color of the shoes to blue. Important note: make sure to change attachment's color and not the slot color. Changing slot's color will apply to all current and upcoming skin placeholders inside that slot. We have it. Blue and red shoes are working with same animations and rig. Cool, right? Even cooler, apart from changing color, we can modify foot attachment and even change the image to any other. Those changes will only apply to active skin. I have explained how to create skins when you already have a rigged character. Sometimes you receive character with all skins in one PSD file. In that case, you can prepare skins right in the PSD file. We'll demonstrate it to you now, using the same shoes example. Select the shoes. Move them into a new group. Rename it and add skin tag at the beginning. The group name will be our skin name. So let's name it red. Now add blue shoes by duplicating red shoes and changing their color to blue. And remove them from the red skin folder. This time I will add the tag directly to the layer names and add skin name right into the tag, which will be skin colon blue. Let's add the same tag to the other blue shoe and export using Spine script. Drag generated JSON file to Spine and import it. All looks good, just shoes are missing. Don't worry, we just need to activate corresponding skin. Cool! A common mistake here is to create a slot for each skin part. Avoid that to keep simple structure in the hierarchy view. In this case, we need to give the same name for each foot. It will make sure that red and blue attachments for each shoe will be placed in one slot. Saying that, I have to add that sometimes different skins can require different layering order for the same part. Let's assume we have two skins. Both have shoes, but one pair goes under the pants, the other goes over the pants. If we add those parts in one slot, we won't be able to set different layering order for those skins. In those cases, my suggestion is to create two slots for each shoe. With that setup, no matter what skin comes next, you can place shoes in either under or over slots. If you think this is not a good way, please tell us in the comments how would you do. I don't have too much experience here. Great, I've covered a lot, but it's just the beginning. And honestly, I can't wrap my head around some good system that can help me to explain you all in order. So why not just to take some use cases and solve them here? Let's assume we have a slot that has three attachments inside, and we need to put all of them inside newly created three skins. Seems easy, right? But let's see if that's the case. First, create three skins and name them red, blue, and yellow. Next, select yellow balloon attachment, open new, and select skin placeholder. We've already done that, remember? Now that attachment will belong to currently active skin, which is yellow. If I select any other attachment and create another skin placeholder, that will also belong to yellow skin. We don't want that. What we need is to activate next skin. Let's pick blue. And then create skin placeholder. But wait, we still have yellow balloons placeholder. So should we create another for the blue balloon? No. In fact, we need to drag blue balloon on existing placeholder while blue skin is active. Similarly, activate red skin and drag red balloon on the same placeholder. It's important to understand that slot or skin placeholders doesn't know anything about skin. So even if we delete all skins, we will still see all slots and skin placeholders. And we can actually create an empty skin placeholder without having any skin created. However, as I told previously, without any active skin, we can't create a skin placeholder from attachment's new menu. Spine needs to know what skin should contain that attachment before creating skin placeholder for it. With all that, let's rename the skin placeholder to something general. Let's name it same as slot. This placeholder will contain all attachments depending on what skin is active at the moment. Video is over 10 minutes long, so I will finish it here and continue this series in the upcoming videos. In the next video, we will cover more cases regarding two skins, and lastly, we will be looking at how to skin characters to reuse same animations with different proportions. That should be exciting. To be prepared for that, go check iKey Constraints video I released recently. And if you have experienced some weird situations regarding two skins, share it with us in the comments. Maybe I can cover it in the next videos. Yeah, help me out. I need some more use cases to solve them in the video. That's it. Thank you all. And still with us, our supporters. Thank you.